Fully prepared, hands up everyone. Stretch up really nicely. And to the right. And to the left. Is it just me or am I doing it the opposite way?
No, we're doing it. I'm doing it the opposite way.
All right, shake it up, shake it up. Now our heads to the side and down. The other side. And up above. And again. When you're done with your third one, you can go the other way. When you're done, just roll your shoulders back a few times. Then roll them to the front. And then put your hands up before you. The front. And stretch. Put your head down so you get a nice stretch there.
Oh, oh.
Now we're going to do it to the back if you have any space behind you.
Oh, that feels nicely.
Down dog.
Yes. And shake it up. Shake it up. Give your face muscles just a little bit of a shake there. Make weird faces at us. All right, who's ready for a call today? Ready to have a fabulous morning, fabulous Sunday morning. Say yes.
Yes. Yes.
Once again, I didn't hear you. I want you to say yes.
Yes.
All right. I want you to close your eyes. Take a deep breath in. And then exhale. Take another nice breath in and exhale. On the next breath in, I want you to make sure that you're getting a diaphragmic breath, okay? So inhale for your stomach expanding. Then hold it in for a couple of seconds. Good vibes. And then exhale slowly. We're gonna do it again. Inhale through your nose slowly. Hold it in. Capture every good, amazing feeling that you can get. And exhale and get rid of any piece of morningness that you still have attached to you. Just get it out. And one more time, and then we're going to begin the call. All right, you can open your eyes. And make the sound of unstoppable intensity, guys.
Yeah. I got people to sleep.
Yeah. I have dogs asleep.
I'm in a hotel.
And kids asleep.
Yep, excuses.
What?
All right. Just a few reminders for you guys as far as how to use the Zoom application. If you're on your computer, which is many of you are today, which is kind of exciting, then so the functions are, if you're not on full screen, you can see the different functions when you move your cursor. On the top right corner, there's speaker view. You can toggle between speaker view and what's it called? Gallery view, which is really nice and convenient. You can see everyone on the screen. It's really nice. On the bottom left, you have a function that allows you to mute your audio. next to that, you can stop your video, which we don't want you to do, but you can if you'd like to. Settings, in case something isn't working, you can test your speakers and your mic there. Reminding anyone who has background noise to mute yourselves, although we do kind of want to hear you most of the time so you can join in on the call. But it seems like someone has kind of a windy effect there. So if it's you, you can mute yourselves. Thank you. I think you just did. There's also an option to, if you click on participants down below, you can raise your hand. It's very useful for us so that we don't have to cut each other off. If you want to say something, just raise your hand. I'll call out your name. And that way we can help each other manage the call nicely and enjoy. Recording is up to me. This call is being recorded. It's going to be uploaded to my iinspire page where you can all view this later, or people who missed out on the call. And there's a chat down below as well. The chat down below allows you guys to message everyone, or you could just, you can also private message anyone on the call. And if you'd like a transcript of everyone's, not private, but public messages, you can get it later in case there are links or anything like that that are important to you. I think that's all with the functionality of the call. If you guys have any questions regarding that, you can say so right now. Any questions using the app or the phone?
Nope.
No. Okay, as far as the call, the way it's going to go, when you guys speak, then say your name, where you're from, and what day you're on the 100-day challenge. That way, whoever's on the phone knows what's going on. And also, we keep track of where everybody's at. It just gives us a nice feeling and keeps us, like, posted. So, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's really nice to see everyone's faces here. Welcome to the call. And thanks again for being here on another week, on another Sunday. It's really, really, really amazing to me that you guys are with me, not only on these calls, but on the 100-day challenge, making 2015 count and rock and making it our year. And many of you are probably already feeling that, and many of you are probably feeling the opposite and beating yourselves up for not being good enough. wherever it is that you're at, I'm sure it's a challenge, which is exactly what it's meant to be. And it all really has to do with, you know, the outcomes at the end of the challenge and, you know, the assessments that we do every week in the after action review. And I can guarantee that no matter whatever it is that's going on, if you follow by the rules of the game, you put your goals together, you focus on them daily, you watch the videos, and you do the after action reviews, I can guarantee that you will be surprised by the results that you will get at the end of the challenge. So that's all it takes. It's not supposed to be easy. It's actually supposed to be challenging. You want to get out of your comfort zones as much as possible, and you want to experience that. And being on these calls is already a big step, and so I really, really admire you guys for being on. It means that you're in this. If you are aware of anybody in the group who's gone, who didn't show up for the call, who just stopped, I don't know, participating, and you're aware of that, then please take it upon yourself to check up on them or make sure that, you know, they have the support that they need, the accountability that they need, or let me know so that we can make sure that it's powerful for all of us. All right?
Right.
Cool. So, just like last time, I'm going to keep you guys updated on how it's going for me. But I actually want to start with one of you. So, who is it that's with us on the phone, by the way, just so I know?
Jana.
Oh, Jana. Okay, it's my friend from here from Israel, Jana. Hey, Jana. Jana's not going to be on for very long. She's here for accountability reasons for me, right?
Yeah.
All right. So I will explain in just a bit. But is there anyone who wants to begin today and tell us how it was? Jana, you can start too, by the way.
Karen wants to.
I see Karen who wants to, but Karen, you're on mute. So just take yourself on mute and we can start with you.
And then I raised the wrong hand. Did you notice?
Yeah. You raised your real hand.
Yeah. Okay. I'm sleepy.
Hi, Karen.
Good morning. I read you Katuna, but do you say Katana?
Katana. Yeah.
I find this so amazing that I look at my list. I look at my list when I'm at work. I look at my list at night. I look at it and I'm like, oh shit, I haven't done that. And I run, you know, whatever it is, get the computer, get the book, get the whatever it is that I have to do. And I've never made progress like this. I really have never been a goal setter. So it's exciting. The day before yesterday, Friday night, I just said, okay, this is the first day. I'm just tired and I'm not going to finish. And fuck it. That's it. I mean, hello. To yourself, you're doing great. Take the fucking day off. Not that I didn't accomplish anything, but when I saw my list and I still had, you know, kind of some big things to do, I went, it's fine. And I really, really, I think I've told you, you know, I've never really set goals before. I'm working on creating a nonprofit. And the most amazing thing happened, you know, I always have an issue when I see people say, oh, you know, I'm blessed. Sometimes people are really, I have an issue myself with that. And not with them saying it, with me. And yesterday, for the first time ever, I thought, wow, I'm really blessed.
Wow.
And it's because of this challenge moving me forward.
Wow. That I think that deserves a round of applause, everybody.
Yeah, thanks. It was a big deal.
I love that, Karen. Thanks for setting a positive tone for our call today. I love hearing that, especially because I think you've really touched on things in the last calls that a lot of us were experiencing about, you know, where it's challenging and difficult and not so easy to work with a task list and do everything that we say we'll do, and just having life come in the way and not having enough time and having this job and everything that you mentioned last time. And hearing about, you know, the progress and the fact that it's making a difference for you is just so tremendously inspiring, especially because you're at a point in your life where, like we said, you really deserve it. And this is your time. And so thank you for that. And I'd love for you to share it even more with us as we go along, just so that we tap into that, whatever it is. And you know, the way that this challenge works, you're all going to see it's a roller coaster. If you're really on the challenge, it's going to be a roller coaster. You're going to have the ups. You're going to have the downs. You're going to have everything in the middle. You're going to be scared. You're going to be happy. You're going to be excited. It's like a roller coaster of emotions. But, you know, it's a safe roller coaster. And at the end, you go back and you go, woo, that was crazy, but so much fun. I want to go again. So every time we have, well, we're going to have people on the call who are at different points of the roller coaster. And I think, the key here is, you know, grabbing hold of the person who's at the fun side of the roller coaster and trying to tap into that and get there as well. So it's good to have you on this call, Karen, and thank you for sharing that.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Yahli.
Now, I know that Jana is with us for a shorter time. Jana, do you want to tell us about your week?
All right. So I'm Jana. I'm from Israel. There's a accountability body. About my week. I thought a great week. I think I made a major progress in all my goals, and I'm really proud of myself, and I like it. But it's a bit scary because now I have I'm expecting for myself to be as good as I was in the last week. So I'm a little bit afraid that I won't be good enough.
Yeah. I get what you're saying, but you always have contrast, so.
So that's why I'm here.
Yeah, that's true. All right, so I'll do you a favor as well, and I'll share with everybody. So I had a bit of a challenging week, to be honest, to say the least. So for me, I'm at the point of the roller coaster where I tried to kind of get off the ride, and that didn't work. So I tried hiding under the seat, but that didn't work either. So I just puked my whole way.
That's probably worse, hiding under the seat. Okay.
Yeah. So it's been quite a bumpy ride this week, and I think most of it was because I let myself kind of fall into the excuses of everyday life, and you know, it's funny to me because I put this group together. I'm like, wait, I can't fuck up, you know, it's my responsibility, yet I do tend to be a real person after all, and I have my challenges as well. And this week was my sister's bachelorette party. She's getting married on Friday, and so hold on one sec, whoever it is that's windy, it might be Jana, I don't know, but mute yourselves, please. It's a really nice effect, but So a part of what was allowing me to kind of, you know, push things aside was that, you know, just being caught up in organizing my sister's wedding and all these things. But also just like the challenges, you know, the week beforehand, so many opportunities came my way. And this week I was a little bit afraid of acting on them. And also, you women out there can understand me that there's a point in a month that we tell ourselves it's okay. And all these regular excuses. But, you know, the difference, I think, was that throughout the challenges and throughout the days that I wasn't being as effective as I wanted to and wasn't really exceeding my own expectations or getting where I wanted to go, I was very aware of that, and I was constantly trying to figure out strategies and ways to overcome that. And I was also, I have Jana as my accountability buddy, so I was also discussing that with her and still, you know, forcing myself to write my wins to her at the end of the day, like I told you I do, and all these things. And Jana and I came up with an accountability solution that I'm taking upon myself this week. And John is like, I'm going to call on both your calls, and I'm going to make sure that you share this with everybody.
Oh, yes.
So, yeah. So here I am. So a part of what I realized would keep me accountable was, I told you in the beginning that I was creating a video blog of my journey throughout the 100-day challenge, because this is what originally kept me accountable the first time I was doing this. The only difference between then and now is that back then I was doing my video blog, I was sending it out to my coach, so I didn't want to mess it up. You know, I was like, this is going to my coach every single day. I don't want to make a fool out of myself, so I better do it. And this time around, I don't have the coach. And I don't know, some of you may have gone on my channel and seen that since day four, I haven't really blogged. So what I decided to do is make all of you guys my coach this time around. And as, you know, as unnatural as it may be, send out my daily video blog and share it with the group every day so that you guys expect it. And if you don't see it, you can be like, what's going on? So yeah, Javin knows it's hard for me to say, but that's kind of what I'm guaranteeing doing starting now. you all get to get my daily blog and see how I'm doing every single day, whether it's a good day or a bad day. That's just gonna be the way it's gonna be. And so you guys get to keep me accountable. I think that deserves a round of applause.
Yeah.
Yay!
Woo! Yeah.
Thank you. Do you want to say something?
Other than being accountable, is there some way that we can support you and help you besides holding you accountable?
Thank you for asking that. I'd love to share more of my actual plans with you guys and my goals that I'm working on. And I think I could do that throughout my blog, if not to waste time on this call, but I'll see how we move forward with the call. And if there's time, I'll share it with you here. But definitely, you guys have a lot to do with some of my goals, because iinspire is not just the name of my channel, it's a community that I've been dreaming of putting together my whole life, and not my whole life, but the last couple of years, and it's a community of self-development, and I think you guys are pretty much it so far for me, so if you guys could help it come to life, that would be amazing. So thank you for asking, Karen. And not being shy to ask me where my blog post is if it doesn't show up on the channel, on the group. Thank you. So thank you, Jana, for forcing me to do this. Was there anything else that I was supposed to do on the call? Jana? I don't know,
it was on mute, so it was to apologize. No, that was great, I approve. And I want to say to everybody that you should poke on her if you don't see the blog. And you may use all means, I approve it personally. If there's any problems, just turn out to me, okay?
We can virtually slap her.
Yeah, there's a slap function on the bottom. All right, everybody. Who else wants to share about?
Okay, I'm going to back it off now. Okay, so good luck for everybody, and thank you, Yahli. I love you.
I love you too. Thank you so much.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
I'll share.
Yes.
Oh, sorry. Is somebody else sharing?
I think that Andrea raised her hand, and then Robyn, you can go after her. Okay.
Hey, good morning, everybody.
Hi.
I'm Andrea, and I'm actually from St. Pete, Florida, but I'm in Norfolk.
Morning, hello.
Hey, good morning. I just actually kind of. The reason why I'm here in Norfolk is I've returned from Afghanistan, a deployment, and I'm here on medical hold, and it'll probably be another few months before I get home, but it wasn't the welcome home I wanted, but regardless, the one thing that I have to say about this call, I'm going to use your analogy on the roller coaster. This past week, when I signed up, I think it was, actually I'm on day 8. When I signed up, I had it in my head that I was already several days late. I didn't start on the first. I didn't even know about the challenge. And then when I started seeing it on the UPW page, I kept thinking to myself, well, you know, when you sign up, you're going to be thinking you're behind and you got to catch up. And then I was like, no, don't think that way. But it did manifest itself earlier this week, where I just stopped doing the challenge for about 3 days because I felt overwhelmed and I didn't know what I was doing and things just seemed complicated. But then I started thinking, if I hadn't gone to UPW, I wouldn't have been thinking that's a bunch of bullshit, because that's what I said. I went to USO here on base and printed out my massive action plan. I put it in this binder. And the reason why I put it in this cutie one is because then the guys won't touch it. But I started, you know, putting things in order. I took notes. I watched videos over. Yeah, in my head, I'm kind of thinking I'm behind, but not really, because things are starting to make sense. And I want to thank you, Karen, because I watched the video from last week's call. And you said something that just really struck me, where you said that you feel like you're trying to save your life. And in some ways, I kind of feel that way. But in a way, I just kind of feel like I'm trying to gain back my life that I knew that early in my 20s, what I've wanted to accomplish, I hadn't ever done. But this 100-day challenge is something that's really just, you know, like you and your goals. I've never wrote them down. I've never, you know, it just seems such a hassle, and, you know, they never work. You just kind of work that in. And I also want to thank you, Yahli, because I watched your videos and I thought to myself, you know what, I started doing video blogs myself. I just keep them in my phone for now because I have thoughts about how things have happened over the past year, and I am where I'm supposed to be. And I just really actually want to thank this community, because I've been, even in this short amount of time, I've kicked a lot of ass, more than I have. And, you know, I'm priming, I'm, you know, getting, I write down what my, you know, I write them down. After I prime, you know, the way Tony had taught us, so that I have them, you know, to look at, because 2015 is my year. I've been saying that for so many years, but it's this and UPW. I mean, I can't. Oh, and the roller coaster. I feel like I just got on, and you know that first, you know, that anxiety that you feel when you're going up, you know, because it's going to get, well, I was going up that roller coaster. I'm like, oh my God, I'm not even ready. My seatbelt's not even on. What am I going to do? You know, that kind of thing. And it's on. I'm ready to roll now. So I'm good to go.
All right.
Yeah. Right
on. Thank you.
So, yeah, thank you for serving. I just want to say thank you. That's it. Thank you for serving. Thank you for doing what you do. I appreciate it. And anybody else here that's a veteran, I appreciate everyone.
Absolutely.
Well, part of the challenge for myself is I'm just going to put it out there. I talked to my wife about this. I've been diagnosed with PTSD, but I'm not claiming that for myself now. That's not my story.
That's right.
As my psych and my psychologist, when I talk about things that I'm doing, like UPW, I got kind of chastised by my psychologist, Tony Robbins, you know, I'm like, whatever. So I just keep stuff to myself. And you want to call me PTSD, then you can call me PTSD. But I will tell you that my nightmares aren't as often. I've been writing them down, my dreams. And they've actually, some things are, the past 2 days, I've noticed that some wonderful things have been happening in my dreams, and they're not like crazy. You know, they're just, now I feel like my dreams are trying to tell me something, and I think it has a lot to do with my challenge. I'm just putting that out there. It's awesome.
Wow. Beautiful.
Very cool.
Great on.
Amazing.
Rock.
Amazing.
Rock.
Karen. Hi.
Yes, Karen. And then it's Robin's turn, because we always keep skipping her.
No, I'm gonna let you know that you're not alone, and I'm on day 8 too. So we're here together, and I had signed up also early and I just didn't make the time to do those goals. So anyways, we're both on day eight. I like day eight because it's on the 18th. It's not necessarily, it's working for me that way. And just like I said, you're not alone. Hey, I'm here too. So reaching out to you.
Perfect. Go day eight. Awesome. Robyn.
Hello. Hey. I am on day 12.
Yes. So,
one thing I have to say is really helpful is Karen is my accountability buddy. So, you know, when we have down days or high days, we could share that with each other. And it's been really helpful. And, you know, I haven't accomplished all my things on my list every day. And, you know, trying to get back into shape is a lot harder. And so I've been super tired, but I have stuck with working out every day and drinking my 100 ounces of water every day. And I have gotten a few good wins, and I'm trying not to beat myself up for not finishing everything on my list, but I just need to make sure whatever I put on there, I could finish. You know, I got so many things going on, but it really is helpful to have Karen is my buddy, but
thank you, and you've been wonderful too. And you're doing awesome. You're doing great.
That's how are you?
So cool. So proud of you girls. Yeah. If some of you don't have accountability buddies and you'd like to have one, I really truly recommend it. After this call, you can definitely, first of all, you can use the chat below and see if anybody is looking. But also after the call, you can use the wall in the group and see if anybody else, even someone who's not on this call, is looking for accountability buddy. Really, really, truly recommended. Like I mentioned, Jana and I, my accountability buddy, we started together on a program, becoming accountability buddies. We became best friends, and ever since, we wake up every single morning together on a call, and it just changed our lives for the better in so many different ways. It's really hard to describe, and it doesn't matter. She doesn't live close to me. We don't meet that often in person, but we can still be best friends because what how much we empower each other throughout our lives. And it's really a different kind of friend to have someone there for you who's willing to, you know, not like risk not looking good and being in your face, but making sure that they, you know, help you gain what's important to you in your life and make it happen. They challenge you to do that. And that's the type of friends that, you know, you want to be around. Tony talks about it too. You're the sum of the people around you, and you want to be around the type of people who will challenge you, not those who are trying to be nice and making sure that you'll like them, you know? Mm-hmm. Perfect. So who else wants to tell us about about their week?
It's MP from Lubbock, Texas. It's your boy. How are you guys doing?
Great. What's up, hey, MP.
Good morning.
You guys... you know, just going through the goals and everything, you know.
How's the carpet?
Just like you were saying, Yahweh, as well. Mine's Mike. Oh, it got the carpet down. I wasn't crazy, but I put things up.
Is everybody getting him a little bit?
It's smooth and it's energy.
Yeah. Hey, yes. Hey, MP, sorry, but your connection is kind of cutting you off a little bit.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, but you get cut off every few seconds. If you can see if there's a way for you to improve that, maybe connect through your phone at the same time or something like that.
And hey, we're in the U.S. Have great internet service here.
Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can hear you, but you get you freeze.
Just cutting out as I freeze up.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like right
is
now.
Is it better for me? Better for all of us.
No, you continue to freeze up. It's something with your internet connection.
What you can do, MP, is we'll go with someone else in the meantime, and you can call in through the phone just so that you can share. If you can hear us fine, then it's cool. But just for sharing, you can call in through your phone so we can also hear you without getting cut off.
Okay, let somebody else share and I'll call in.
All right, perfect. Cool. So who said they wanted to share before?
Oh.
Karen, go ahead. Yeah.
Which Karen?
Yes, Karen, yeah.
So I am on day 8. I understand about feeling behind. I have had a roller coaster. I understand that's how life is, ups and downs. And I'm really glad that I do have Robyn to talk to and have an accountability partner. It's been very good. There's some things that I haven't finished, but I also put more emphasis on the main goal. So I'm kind of beating myself up, but then the other part is I'm spending more time on my priority list of certain goals. The one thing I haven't done is share on Facebook because I feel like I'm bitching more than being
that'd be me.
there's a part of me that it's like I want to share these things, but I want to have a happy, positive attitude, and I just don't want to bitch about the day. But then I feel like it is a safe place to go ahead and talk about things. I just haven't gotten there quite yet. So maybe one thing this week is I'll share a little bit more and go on to Facebook and that'll be good for me, I think. And also, as Ray was saying, with this group, I feel like, you know, I need to start feeling that I'm not alone in this and that we're all going through our own things and we're here for support. And I guess that's just, those are challenges. I think one of the things with Robyn this week was she kind of caught me on, especially talking about goals. And I was very hesitant about how I was wording things. And I would, I know if I say it out loud, then I definitely have to do it. So I understand what you're saying about, okay, if I say this out loud, that means I really have to do this. And it needs to be done. And it's not just saying something to myself, but I'm putting it out there in you know, life. So anyways, that's kind of where I am right now. And it is early and I'm glad that on a Sunday that I'm here and all these beautiful people and I am excited about this challenge. So I really appreciate and thank every one of you.
Yay, Karen. Thank you so much for sharing that. And you know, I really want to say this personally to you, but I'm saying it to everybody. Share. There are a few amazing effects that happen when you share. The first one is when you get things out, you actually find out that they're not as bad as you think they are. Sometimes all we need is to get them out. And we're already, you know, we're not just the average person, right? We've been to these events. We're pretty much in a level of awareness that we know how to not only coach other people, but we've seen and heard different aspects of the way things are. And sometimes it's really hard when it's in our head to have a look at that and see what it really looks like. But when we share it, we take things out, we say them out loud, sometimes we're able to see for ourselves, you know, how insignificant or small or, you know, see from a different point of view. And That's the first benefit of sharing. Another benefit of sharing is you have no idea what you give somebody when you share. Because when someone has an ability to feel that they're not alone and they can connect to what you're going through, not only can they provide you with maybe a possible breakthrough, but they for themselves get the strength to be with that. And when you see it through someone else, it's so much easier to be there and say, oh, wait, you know, if they're going through it, I see it's not the end of the world. It's okay that I'm here too. Maybe like it's worth the fight. You know, once we try to make everything look good and pretty, we're actually not breaking our patterns and we're not putting ourselves out of our comfort zones. And that's exactly what it's about. So again, I repeat, this challenge is not about feeling great. It's just not, you know, if you feel great all the time, you're doing something wrong. You know, Karen feels great today, but she felt like not so great last week and she was worried and everything. And I don't want to guarantee this, but she probably won't feel like amazing throughout the whole entire challenge. Sorry to break that to you. And the other Karen is the opposite. Maybe you guys are doing like, maybe something with a Karen, you're replacing each other. But you know, it's really, really important to share even more so when you're downhill than when you're going uphill, even though it's more challenging. And like I said, for myself, I'm gonna start doing that too. So hopefully I'll be an example to you guys. And I know that I was talking to Claudine, who's not with us today here. She'll probably be on the other call, but I was talking to her last week and she was, you know, having trouble with some of the things on the challenge. So I wanted to kind of get a one-on-one with her and see how I can help her out. And when she was saying like how she felt, she really emphasized all these, you know, the things that were going wrong or she wasn't doing on her task list. And I remember in my first blog that I blogged 2 years ago, when I was doing the challenge on my own, and there were such tough moments. And like I said, I was so accountable. I was recording videos even on my worst days. And so I pulled that out and started letting her watch like one or two parts of me while I was being really challenged on the challenge. And when I was being really vulnerable. And it's when she saw, I was embarrassed to show it to her, but it's when she saw that all of a sudden, you know, it hit her that was normal. And she's like, oh, wow, hold on. So if you went through that and you accomplished your goals, then I can too. And another beautiful, beautiful pointer, I kind of wish she was here on the call, but there was a beautiful pointer with her that I actually want to tell you guys because it wasn't like too personal, so I want to share. That really helped her out was she was feeling very overwhelmed, you know, throughout the challenge, and some of you may feel that. If not today, then you know, like some of the days. She's feeling very, very overwhelmed, and the way that she described it, stressed. She was like, wow, I'm really, really stressed. I'm waking up in the middle of the night sometimes because I'm not like, you know, following through with my goals and it's just too much for me to handle. And I told her, you know, look at how our minds trick us sometimes, you know, and how much language really, really counts. Think of an emotion like love, okay? Love, when you really think about love, is it a positive or a negative?
Positive.
I think we all agree it's positive. But if you really imagine the emotion, can you tell how close it is to being scared to death and fear and and this like overwhelming anxiety? Can you like when you really imagine love, when you're crazy in love, aren't you scared to death at the same time? I mean, love is kind of a sense of fear and worry and panic. You love this person so much, you're so afraid of losing them, or so afraid of this moment passing by. But you don't say that out loud. You don't like look at the person you're in love with and say, oh my God, I'm so anxious and worried, you know? The way you describe it is, wow, I'm in love. And you actually appreciate having something to worry about. So it's all in the language and the way we interpret things. So I told her, yes, you're overwhelmed, but isn't abundance what you wanted? And how about understanding that what you're feeling now, that you're going, that you have a task list and you have these goals and you have all these things that you expect yourselves to do, and you're at the next level of life. You're this player in the game now. You're not a watcher. You're not an observer. You're a player. You're on the court. You're getting the balls thrown at you and you're trying to catch them. What if that was abundance? What if that was what abundance feels like? What if that's that's your expansion of growth? And they're just the growing pains that come along with it, because when you take on big challenges, you're going to face, when you take on like big goals, you're going to face big challenges at the same time. This is what it feels like. Maybe it's not supposed to feel any better. It's actually a great feeling what you're feeling. And she had a breakthrough at that moment. Like, she really understood that the way she interpreted the abundance that she was feeling and the richness of her life and the life, you know, that's what life feels like. There's action, stuff is happening. She was just interpreting it as stress and telling her the wrong word. And I challenged her. I said, until next Sunday, your goal is to, every time you feel that anxiety or stress, you say abundance. And even if you're describing it to your boyfriend or someone next to you, you'd be like, oh my God, I'm so abundant, I can't handle it. And she took it on, and it's been amazing. She's been sharing with me. So, you know, I hope that inspires you in some way. And like I was saying about sharing, I'm actually throwing a link into the chat room right now, and I'll give it to you guys later. It's a beautiful TED Talk by Brene Brown, who speaks about the power of vulnerability. She actually has another TED Talk afterwards, because on the first one, she talks about vulnerability and how amazing it the amazing insights she had about being vulnerable and how much that could give her life. And what's funny is the next TED Talk is about how when she had her first TED Talk, she was so vulnerable in sharing it that she panicked afterwards, felt so bad about it, was worried it was going to make her collapse. And then she got another insight out of that experience. That was another vulnerable moment for her. And she shared another TED Talk on that. I really recommend having a look at that and connecting that to what I said about sharing on the group. It's so tremendously powerful, and really it's nothing but power to have the power to share both your weaknesses and your power. And the reason that the weaknesses are also powerful is because we're not in a place of sharing weakness because we're hopeless and we don't want to move forward. We share weakness because we're ready to overcome it. Mm-hmm. And so it's power. And Karen, you want to show us what that is?
There it is.
This is The Gift of Imperfection. This is one of her books, and it's really, it's a great book. I went through her Oprah classes, and it was about journaling and how sometimes people, they really numb themselves to certain situations instead of feeling it. And what are your numbing agents? Whether it's, there are just certain things. It was really empowering. It was also, it's something that, you know, what would you tell your younger self that you know now? There's so many wonderful things. I love how raw she is. I mean, she's just like, she's just there. And between her and Tony Robbins, and of course there's many, many other people, I just love the way she goes about things. So if you can look at the TED Talk or any of her others, or even on Oprah, like OWN, how scared she was to even talk to Oprah, and also giving yourself permission to do these things. She puts these little notes in her pocket about, I have the permission to laugh and be silly, but I also have the permission to be vulnerable and to have certain things in the day, and just giving yourself that it's okay. It's okay to feel this way. And I really, really love her. So yeah, thank you for bringing her up.
Awesome. I love
her. And her books are also available on Audible. They have audiobook versions. So just wanted to throw that out there. I'm not much of a reader, but I'll listen to a good audiobook.
Yeah. And I was just going to ask, how many people are journaling during this?
Me.
So that's something that I feel like I need to go ahead and do. I always feel better when I write things down if I'm not able to say them, or dreams, because it tells, it's something that just another release.
Totally. I don't do it either, but it's something that I would want to do as well. So those of you journaling, feel free to share what you're journaling about. Mm-hmm. It's awesome. Okay, so we have a bunch of people who didn't share with us yet, so go ahead.
Can you
go next?
Is the MP for Loba?
Oh, MP, you're back. Yes.
Oh, yeah, I'm back. Can you guys hear me without static or anything?
Yeah, perfect. Yes.
Better? Yeah. Okay, perfect. Yeah, starting off with that, yeah, I do a journal every single day, and you know, that's something I do. You know, just something to keep it lively. There's my Mickey Mouse. That's the one where I do my journal. Just got it at, you know, at Walmart, and just journal every single day. And the first thing I do is I write down at least 3 to 5 things that I'm grateful for every single day. So, you know, my 2 feet hitting the ground, I'm grateful for being alive. You know, everybody has different things that we're grateful for. Then I just write down about my day, what's going on, what was good, what can I improve, what can I do better, and expectations for that day. And I've been doing this for the last, I guess, about 3 years already. At the end, I always write down my 10 goals. And those are my goals that I want to do in the next 30 to 60 days. And anywhere from income, changing, doing different things. And it really does help in work. I was a door-to-door salesman for alarm business called Vivint Security. And on there, I told myself that I was going to be within the top 10 sales reps. Rookies out of, you know, 200, and I was actually number 5, and I was 130th best salesman out of 3,000 people around the world. And I did 106 sales in 4 months, and I made over $60,000 in 4 months. So, you know, it really does work, because it comes to life, because you know what you're going for, and I've done it for a long time, and it's just something that really, really helps, because of the 100-day challenge, writing the goals. It's just, you know, it might be the same goals that you have, but it's just repeating them and cementing them in your head, because now it's like, yeah, I still have I got index cards, different color index cards all the time around with me to remind me of my goals and what I want to do. And I've learned that all the time, you know, write an index card that I put on my, you know, when I drive, you know, right beside my speedometer, and it says what I'm grateful for. So just these little bitty reminders is always reminding us, because there's more negative than there is positive. So we definitely want to do that. I'm doing a blog as well. Yahweh, I've got one that's already been started. I'm working on it as well. And mine's michaeldpadilla.com, michaeldynamitepadilla.com. And so I've already got one set up and doing some more work to it right now as we speak as well. I've got to put my story on it. Got a lot of things going on. And, you know, what this challenge is, you know, just like Gary said, nothing's easy. If it was easy, everybody would do it. And everybody would have everything they want. So we are the 3%ers, and that's what we got to remember. And I had a tough day. I think it was Thursday. And I'd done a lot of things. And I was like, why am I beating myself up if I've accomplished a lot of things? Yes, there was a couple of things I could have done better or I could have done. But what I found out is, you know, I gave it all I had. You know, I don't know if you guys know Art Williams. He says, do everything you can and do a little bit more. do all you can and a little bit more. And that little bit more can be the turning point for you. And so, you know, I beat up myself on Thursday. Friday, got up, and it was just like, you know, I was overwhelmed on Thursday of all the things I need to do. And then on Friday, it's just like everything smooth like a river. I mean, it was just like, wow, this, oh, man, I got this. This is easy. So, you know, it's just the way we think of things. And I know that, you know, if you talk about something, it's just a dream. But if we envision it, it's exciting. But if we plan it, it's possible. And the best thing about it is if we schedule it, it becomes real. We write it down. It becomes, you know, we grab those thoughts, put them on mind, put them on paper, and we can actually make those goals happen. And, you know, I'm actually running another team here in Lubbock for alarm business. And I'm so fortunate. I'm working with a multimillionaire that actually wrote a book with Brian Tracy. And so his name is Mark Cisoli. And he's personally working with me, mentoring me to help me build a team. And he already told me he's going to help me write my book. And, you know, he's been through a lot of different trainings. He's got two more books coming out. Very, very, very successful guy. So, you know, we go and grow through things for a reason, you know. You know, and I love my little girl because I picked up my tablet last night, and she's with her mom this weekend, and it's crazy. She has videos that I didn't even know that she put up, and I was just like, wow, so much wisdom that little girl already has by herself. Just like, hey, my dad told me this, and this is what I've learned, and I listened to Tony Robbins with my dad, and she says, you know, don't let your fears stop you from anything. I mean, she was just going out, and I'm like, wow. So, you know, you're growing when you see a mirror, a little image of you. That's wow. I mean, I had personal development 14 years ago. She's 6 years old, and I just can't even imagine what's fixing to happen with her and her life and her being a leader. So this challenge has really pushed me. Yahli, I'm proud of you getting that blog up, because that's definitely something that it can help out a lot of people. It's not easy to do, but it's definitely something that stays there forever. So appreciate all you guys. And, man, just do this.
Yeah. Let's give Michael a round of applause.
I say so. God damn.
Yeah, we have some powerful, powerful people in here. I love it. Thank you for sharing that, Michael. I love your insights, and I love the quotes that you have, and I love your daughter. And it would be great if you shared the link to your blog with us, and you can also share it on the group. You guys, feel free. I know how people usually don't like people sharing personal things on their groups or whatever, but I actually encourage that. You know, the reason that we're a community is to support each other, and whatever it is that you feel that you're doing that has value and can give value to other people, please feel free to share it on the group. We're here to support each other. Feel free to ask me to like your pages. I'll do that. And share with us what your goals are. If it's making something come to life, or trying to get in touch with someone who can help you do something, and we can support you on that, and make sure that you share that with us. Because, you know, accomplishing something on your own sometimes is more challenging, and you'd be surprised when you shout your dreams out loud what you can accomplish. Some people can connect you to the right person or have the right resources for you, even if you least expect it. So it's definitely something I'm going to do on my blog, and I encourage you guys to do it as well. Thank you, Michael. Who else didn't share with us and would like to share? I think, Maria, you wanted to share with us before. You're on mute, though, so we can't hear you. We still can't hear you for some reason. Nope, not working. Okay, you want to try to do what MP did and call us from the phone at the same time? And we can have someone go in the meantime. All right, perfect. Thank you. So who else wants to share in the meantime? Sure. Yes, Vivian.
First of all, it's been such an amazing and empowering being part of this group. I feel completely humble. I I'm on week lesson number 10. I actually listen in the morning before I go to work to the lessons, and I listen to them again at night before I go to bed. I've been breaking down my challenges. One of my biggest challenges is to lose weight. I'm doing little by little. Every day is it's work. But I am doing it. I'm sorry, I'm getting so emotional. I started exercising. I see the steps every day. Everything is just empowering me to motivate me to do more. I never thought that this challenge will get to me so emotional, but it's I know it's been a roller coaster ride, but every day I'm working very hard on every lesson, and hopefully I'll be getting to my goals where I want to get in at the end of this 100 days.
Wow, Vivian, that is so touching and so beautiful to see you, you know, so moved by what you're putting yourself through and what you're willing to do for the goals, and you so deserve them. Do you want to share a little bit of what you think makes you emotional about that?
First of all, that makes me emotional that I can still believe in humanity. There's people like you that do care and they have the time. So, you know, there's still good people out there. So that gives me more of motivation that everything is not negative, that everything, you know, that there's hope for a lot of wonderful things and meeting another wonderful people all over the world. It's like I have an extended friends all over. It's just such a great feeling. And actually, you know, you guys want to listen and you care. Also, of course, you're great. I need to improve my health. That's one I need to get better, because being overweight is not healthy. So that is also another reason why I needed to get something going. It was just do it or do it. It was just not another option. Thank you, guys. Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. All right, Vivian.
First of all, Vivian, you rock. Just like a lot of people right here. I think that deserves a round of applause.
Hey.
Thank you. Thank you so much for not only sharing that, and thank you for the acknowledgement. I think we all felt it. Thank you for putting yourself out there and for demanding something different this year. And that is just so much inspiration and empowerment for all of us. You know, be on the challenge with people like yourself who are really in the game. That is so encouraging and beautiful and amazing. And thank you so much for being authentically you. And let us support you in any way possible. Just, you know, share as much as you can. As far as losing weight and getting healthy, I've been kind of teasing you guys a little bit on the cleanse that I've been doing. I thought that I would share more. Maria, now we can hear you, but we need you to mute your audio for that. So I've been on a cleanse. I'll tell you a bit about it now and remind me later, and I'll share more details with you. It's called Curium, and I got it online. They actually don't ship to Israel, but my friends had such tremendous success with them that I had to order it and have my friend deliver it to Israel when he was coming here. Purium, if you search Purium, it's like all over the internet. The beautiful thing about this cleanse is, or their whole nutritional program is that it's completely pure organic greens. It's you start with a 10-day cleanse where you're pretty much fasting, but you're still giving your body all the nutrients that it needs, to an extent that I haven't seen any other, you know, kind of product that you can buy online do. That still like keeps you healthy and is dangerous for you. It's not about having any like protein shakes or any powders like that. It's like pure green. I'll give you, someone's typing really loudly. I'm not sure. but I'll be happy to share the actual info for you. And Purium is Purium. I just wrote it in the window.
Okay.
But also, just like I said, I want to build a community of empowerment. So a part of what I'm doing is I'm trying out different things, and then I'm trying to get us discounts for them and see how we can all try them out. So definitely I'm into continuing this because I was doing the 10 days. I lost so much weight. I went dress sock shopping for my sister's wedding. I felt amazing. I was like, wow, this is so worth it that I can't stop. So I'm not just doing the cleanse. I'm going to continue. And I have another friend who's coming to Israel soon. So he's going to give me more. And I have $50 coupons that I'm going to get through a friend soon. Same friend that sold it to me. And I'll give it to you guys. You can either buy like a sample of something for about that much, or you can just get the whole cleanse and get a $50 discount. You get to decide what to do with it. So I'm actually going to buy a bunch of coupons and then give them to you. And if you guys want to buy coupons too and sell them to your friends, you can do that as well. I'll give you more details on it on the group. Feel free to bug me about it, okay?
But did you say a 10-day fast? Let me just clarify.
You don't like not eat. It's that you're not going to eat the foods you're used to eating. You're fasting off of processed foods and you're like,
I don't eat them.
You're getting a bunch of water. You're getting all your greens in. You have like 3 shakes of these a day. You have a sweet shake at night. You have, what do you call them? Crap, I forgot. Sorry. but you're getting everything your body needs. And you're going to feel amazing. So maybe first like 3 days are kind of challenging because you're hungry. But after 3 days, you actually feel more energy, more like, and you kind of like, it's so easy suddenly not to eat that you're actually enjoying yourself. And you feel really good really fast. I lost the 7 pounds that I lost in on the first 3 days, or maybe the
oh my god day.
And I had to stop because I got my period in the middle. Like, women don't do it during your cycle. It's not smart. So I stopped and I began again this morning. So I still have quite a few days to go.
Does it fill you up?
It, like I said, the first couple of days are challenging. I didn't like the shakes so much. They don't, you know, all the diet programs online, they try to imitate yummy food. You know, they'll give you like a cereal or a chocolate bar and it's supposed to be healthy. What I like about this one is they don't try to do that. It's like, it's greens, okay? It's not the yummiest thing in the world. The first 3 days I was like, how do I do this? How do I drink? And there's a Facebook group and I was talking to everyone and asking them and they're like, don't worry, after the 3rd day, you're going to start liking it and your taste buds are going to change. And suddenly like a cucumber is the best thing you've ever eaten. And And you know, I was like, it's worth the try, right? I got it all the way from the States, and they brought it over here for me. I'm not going to mess it up, especially before my sister's wedding. And it's so true. Now I'm like having it all the time. Like, I like it, which is fun because it's so healthy. And it's not supposed to be like a chocolate bar, and you're not supposed to be super crazy full, but you don't get cravings anymore. And that's what it's about. So you're not full, but if you're not craving food, then you don't mind not being full. You actually kind of like the clear feeling and the light feeling. And after only 3 days, everyone was like, whoa, you lost weight. Like, I don't know if you guys can tell on camera because it's like a little bit different. But in real life, it was like a big difference. I'm telling you, I went dress shopping and it was so fun. It was so fun because I didn't expect in such a short time for it to feel so much better. More details soon, I promise. I really wanted to blog the whole
I'm sure you probably have a lot more energy and you feel a lot better, I bet.
Yeah.
Yes, total difference. Total difference. And it was, I went out with my friends one night and everyone was drinking and, you know, just having fun. And there was so many different snacks around. And I brought like two of these and some cucumber. And everyone was like, at first, like, poor thing. And you know what? Throughout the night, it became from poor thing to that's so cool. And I have never felt better. When we ended the night, we ended it at like 4 a.m. and everyone wanted to go to a restaurant, you know, when people get the munchies in the middle of the night. I was like not hungry. I went with them to the restaurant. I was not hungry and I felt so, so good about myself. So it's really worth it. It's not like you don't have to be on the cleanse for life. It's 10 days. You'll lose between 5 to 20 pounds just on the 10 days. And right after that, you can do the continuation program, which is like one day on, one day off for 20 days. So not only you keep it off, you still lose some weight and you feel more energy. And then you could do what my friends do. My friends, they'll have the shakes around and they'll kind of mix it up within their regular diet throughout the next month. It's easy because you've cleaned yourself out to be more vegan afterwards or not to eat processed foods. So if you can keep that up and at least eat healthy, you're not as hungry and you don't crave all the snacks and the bullshit, then you can integrate it into your meal plans. Like just have a shake in the morning just for the nutrients and then have a regular breakfast, and things like that. It's just, it makes you feel super healthy. And from what I've seen from my friends, they actually kept the weight off, which matters to me because I'm heartbroken when I lose the weight and I gain it back. You know, it's not about the losing. I'm great at losing weight. I hate gaining it back. It feels so bad. So I've seen them maintain the weight loss, and that's kind of why I waited for this cleanse for so long, for really long. I ordered it over 6 months ago. And yeah, because the guy who was supposed to bring it to me was a guest at my bed and breakfast, and he never ended up coming to Israel. So it's been shipped around the state to different people who were supposed to get here until I finally got it. And it's worth it.
I have to say that 3 days with no food does sound like an eternity. even though losing weight is one of my top goals, because I have lost weight in the past and regained. There's something else I was going to say, but yeah, 3 days.
Let's do it throughout the 100-day challenge when we get everyone's support throughout. And I'll make sure to get the coupons as soon as possible. I was supposed to get them already.
It's important for somebody that needs to lose weight not to lose too much too fast, because you need to tone while you're losing. Otherwise,
So the whole thing about it, I was trying not to waste our time on this, but I'll do it really quickly. The whole thing about the way it works, actually, like if you see the people who get the best results are the people who normally, you're not supposed to exercise on the cleanse itself, but the people who normally exercise, they tone up really, really well. They get the best results because actually like the lean people, because the way it works, you wake up and you have these amino acids that they patented, and it starts your muscles moving. And then you'll have the green shake and like 2 hours later. And then for the next 2 hours, you're not having anything. So your body is kind of looking for calories, right? Because this is very low calorie. So now it's looking for calories, and what it might do is it can go to your muscles and, mm-hmm. and try to get like calories from your muscles. So you take the amino acids again. And what that does is, again, it works on your muscle. So when your body's looking for calories, it's like, oh, well, muscles are busy. I should go to the fat resources. And that's where you start burning your fat. And it goes like that. You switch it up three times. You do the amino acids. 2 hours later, you have the shake. 2 hours later, the aminos. Two hours later, the shake. So it's smart like that. And then at the end of the day, you have the fiber blend that you get. That's the word I was looking for before. So you get your fibers so that everything kind of comes out the way the way it should. And then and then before you go to sleep, I think it's like the cherry on top. It's all organic. It's organic cherry apothe. I'm not sure how you say that word. But it's this cherry liquid. You mix it up with water. It's pure cherry, like organic. And you'll have that before you go to bed. Not only is it so yummy, but it's really smart because I'm not sure how to say it in English.
Endorphins.
Thank you. your endorphins, it gets them going. So you sleep much better on the cleanse, and it's yummy. And it's a super smart cleanse. You're allowed some flex foods throughout the cleanse, which are only organic. Cucumbers, avocados, kale, spinach, squash, and berries. Also, not as much as you want, but enough to keep you going without suffering and missing like flavors and textures.
The other thing I wanted to say was I wanted to drop the cucumber in the vodka.
Well, I've been putting cucumber in my water with the. It makes it taste good.
Yeah, it does in the water.
All right, so we're kind of running out of time, and I wanted to do a little exercise to finalize the call. Does anyone feel like they didn't cheer today and want to share? We have a few people on, like Kevin, Matthew, Evan. Maria, you called in. Did you end up sharing?
I don't know if you listen to me.
So let's let Maria share before we end the call. Maria.
Hey.
How was your week?
I'm the day 15. Mm-hmm. I've been really stressed because I don't finish the activities. We have three main goals and a lot of daily activities. But I found I can do all the things I said because I don't have the time to do it. I realized that I spend a lot of time in work. Realistic. But I'm doing baby steps and I'm trying to organize. I buy a calendar and a notebook and a lot of things. But I'm drinking water because it's for the first time in my life, I'm drinking water.
Wow.
I have that habit. And I'm also doing the 52 weeks challenge to save money. And I'm doing two. But also, I love the challenge a lot. I'm not doing all the goals and the activities, but I'm in the roller coaster.
That's really cool. Really cool. Round of applause to you. It's really good to hear that you're doing good. I love the fact that everybody's started drinking water on this challenge. It's not like it's written in the manual, but it's almost like everyone takes it as a given. So it's really good. We can actually be like daily water reminders for each other. It's so important to drink water. Tony talks about it at UPW. And there's a great book called The Body's Many Cries for Water. It's a bit of a boring book, I admit, but it has so much quality information. And it's all about, you know, healing through water and preventing diseases and things like that. So it's cool that you're doing that and cool that you're enjoying it as well. Maybe like quick shares from everyone who didn't share with us yet. Just so we know where we're at.
I'll share on the page a little bit later, but everything's going well. I'm on day 10 for 3 days now, just because as far as my roller coaster, being so driven and overachieving, I got to get to the top fast and got to go. And then I missed the journey along the way. And so I'm giving myself permission to enjoy the journey and be gentle with myself. But what I want to share is I had a call from the business coach this week to finally set up my meeting. And we got to talk and we had this awesome call. And because I went to San Jose too, and I was sharing with her, it's the weirdest thing. The Facebook page for Dallas versus what happened with San Jose when I came back, Dallas just went like freaking over the top roller coaster, and San Jose just kind of sat there and just sort of fizzled down a little bit. And she said, I wanted to tell you this. She said it was really interesting that the same thing happened to her, is the leads and the activity that came back from Dallas was way more than San Jose. And so we just started talking about the difference of that. And then I had mentioned your name, Yahli, and I said, yeah, you got to go on our page and see these freaking firecrackers, man. They are just going on fire. And I got an opportunity to share with her. So she wanted to know. And I told her how, for some reason, so many of us coming back from Dallas, we understood how to keep it. You didn't fix me. That didn't work. And then go back into your old freaking story. And we just keep things going by these subgroups. And I shared with her, this was one of them, and then a couple other things. She absolutely was over the top with the feedback and said that she loved it because they talk about that stuff in their meetings. And so she was going to do some snooping on you to see what all the activity was and stuff. She wanted to learn so that they can tell people in future UPWs of what we're doing to make things successful. So
that's awesome.
It was a really super amazing, cool phone call. It was really great. And again, I always tell you thank you, but me too, this 100-day challenge has been great. It has just really made me super conscious, and my subconscious too is creating things going on because I'm so intentional about everything and it's keeping me in check all the time, which is great. And I too have a buddy, and I really I love my buddy because we do our three wins every day, and then we'll text during the day sometimes. And it also keeps me happy and proud of myself. Oh yeah, I had three wins, because I have to connect to myself to write them down. And I loved what somebody said today about the numbing agents. If anybody like me has had any history of trauma, my trauma was so deeply wired in that I subconsciously just go to a numbing agent when something doesn't feel good. And I've had to really work at rewiring all of that my whole life.
Wow.
And so I'm noticing on this 100-day challenge how successful I've actually become with that issue, because this is not a time to be numbing, because there's no snoozing, right, Yahli? There's no snooze button in this challenge. Yeah, we can rest. We can rest and get proud, but no snoozing. But anyway, I just wanted to share that call with the rep that called me. It was just great.
That's awesome, Katana. Thank you. Thank you for sharing, and share more with us about your challenge and your progress in the group for sure. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And I allow anybody to snoop and everything as long as, you know, it empowers other people and contributes to the success of our group and ourselves and everyone else who wants to, you know, push themselves forward. How about Matthew? How are you doing today?
Well, the peaks and valleys, I've actually had all of them this week. I kind of got off track around Thursday. The first part of the week was really good. You know, I kept my, you know, hour in the morning and evening, you know, for personal development. You know, I shut my phone off. I don't have the TV on. You know, I'm watching, you know, I'm either watching a Tony video or another, you know, personal development coach. Also, I use Jim Rohn. There's a book that I do recommend that I found very effective. I bought a few years ago. It's called The Four Seasons of Life. I won't spoil it for you, but you know, it's a book that you know, gives a lot of perspective as far as taking advantage of opportunities, you know, when they present themselves. I've got blessings. You know, I'm going from, you know, one of my jobs starts tomorrow, and I've got used to not working. I mean, it's great. I went to UW. I've got to, you know, do whatever I want, and now, you know, 40 hours a week of my life is going to be spoken for again. But you know, it is a blessing, you know, because by all the time that I'm off, I'm not making money. So and
what job are you starting?
I'm actually starting for Verizon tomorrow.
Cool.
And I'm actually trying to get my – I'm going to be getting my Beachbody quite set up.
Wow.
Everything else has been going great. You know, I'm eating everybody with their cups of coffee this morning. You know, I haven't had a cup of coffee in almost 3 weeks.
Hey.
Yeah, it wasn't easy waking up the first few days, but and you know, my weight loss goal has been met. You know, I've I made it a point to lose a pound a day. You know, I went from, you know, as of January 2nd, I stepped on the scale, I was at 240 pounds. You know, I'm down now. Last time I stepped on the scale, which was 2 days ago, I'm at 226 pounds.
Wow.
I'm going clothes shopping as well. Yeah, it feels good that, you know, it feels good to, you know, get in better shape than where I was, you know, because I've been able to go from last March, I weighed 301, and I was able to get down to 240 and just, I'll never go over that again, but you know, that's not enough anymore. You know, I want to feel better. I want the energy back that I had when I was 195, 200 pounds, which is my ideal weight. So.
Wow. This is totally your time.
Good.
A round of applause. I'm proud of you. And, you know, you said you're not necessarily at the high point of the roller coaster this week. How do you think you can be more accountable? Where do you think we can support you this week?
Well, I feel like I'm on the ride back up. I was kind of all over the place this week. I mean, I was good till about Wednesday. I got late. I thought, well, you know, I'll take the day off. And that day turned into 3 days. You know, as I said, it got to be fun just being lazy and lounging out on the couch watching TV and realized I wasn't making any progress. So, you know, I definitely need to be more participating as far as the 100-day challenge goes. You know, I haven't been posting that much on Facebook. in there or UPW. And, you know, I found out for me personally, when I put myself out there, you know, it's not – accountability isn't as hard as I try to make it.
Yeah. Cool.
Once I put it out there, it all comes.
It's true. It's really true. And I encourage you to share with us too, you know, throughout the week so that we can support you where needed. And, you know, taking days off, I do that. I tend to do that too. I'm independent. I pretty much run my schedule. It can be challenging. To not have to wake up a certain time, not have to have certain rituals, and not really separate the place where you sleep and the place where you work and the different categories of work that you do. And I keep stepping it up and forming new habits around that, whether it's getting out of the house and making myself, you know, work on a certain project outside of the house in a certain location so that I'm focused only on that. Waking up, I have Jana, who is like my morning, you know, accountability buddy. We wake up really early together, even though I don't have a specific reason why. But now I'm putting together reasons why, like a yoga class that I want to attend, and things like that. So that those things can be empowering. I think that you starting a new job is definitely a new page for you. So good luck on that, and awesome, awesome. Good luck this week. You guys, don't forget to do the after action review. It's really important. I also want to apologize for us running a little late. I just want everyone to get a chance to share at least for a few seconds. So Kevin, how's it going for you?
Well, it's going good. I've actually went back and had to reevaluate some of my first initial goals that I set up. And I didn't really abandon them. I just modified them some because as I started into them, I realized, well, I need to change this slightly. So I'm just adjusting the sales a little bit as I go.
Yeah, that makes sense. Just like I said, you want the outcome to pretty much be the same. But I've actually changed my social goal as well. I had a social goal. It was like twice a week of having like a really exciting interaction, whether it's a relationship scene or just fun. And I, you know, the week went on and I realized that I had more important goals for myself. And I didn't mind pushing aside the social for most of these 100 days while I was making some dreams happen. And it's funny because the moment I decided that and pushed that aside and started focusing on you know, bringing myself to the U.S., putting my startup together, then social opportunities actually came up on their own. So it's funny that it works that way.
It is funny it works that way. Yep.
Yeah.
What else? I work from home, so I have to kind of force myself to go out into social situations. So it's so relaxing. You can just sit at the house and feel comfy, and you have to push yourself to get out there sometime.
Yeah, it is. But what do you feel that you've accomplished this week that wasn't like – that was challenging for you?
Actually, I'm actually working on a new design for a product that we're coming out with. And that's pretty much been my entire focus really since mid-December is working on this product. So it's a slow process. It involves not only just my design of it, but having to drag in other people, engineers, and people to do tests for me. So The 100-day challenge has really been good because I've set up better goals in the process of getting this design completed and brought to market instead of just my usual pushing things off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Really cool. Good luck on that. And maybe we guys can also share with each other on the group a little bit about what it is we actually do, because we don't know much about each other, and that could be interesting for us to discover. So if you guys want to share more, definitely encourage you guys to do that. I'll post a message on the group where we can all fill each other in on what we're doing in our lives and just get to know each other a little better.
So thanks. Awesome. I like that.
Do we have anybody on the line who hasn't shared? No. Okay, cool. No. Oh, wait, Evan, right. You didn't share.
With yeah. Spoke to yeah, me. I haven't. Yeah, thanks, Yahli. I haven't shared too much just because I've enjoyed listening to everyone, and I think a lot of everyone's stories is kind of, I was able to relate to them a lot. I'm currently on day, I'm supposed to be on day 15, but a couple of days I've had to double up on some of the goals, which frankly, I'm okay with because I know that I have been studying really hard for a certification exam coming up. And because of that, you know, because I'm driving towards my goal and I'm pushing forward, even in the stressful situations of shoot, I'm, you know, not getting as much done towards my goal as I need to, or I'm staying up late, the next day, I'm always, you know, have the confidence and feeling empowered to move forward and make progress. So in that sense, my mindset towards achieving my goals is good. And I think I still have yet to do the after action review, but I want to make sure that I spend some time and really focus on that. So some good progress and hopefully some more good things to come.
Perfect. That's awesome. What are you getting certified as?
Salesforce admin certification.
Wow.
Yeah. Cool. So looking for a job right now, and hopefully that validates the purpose of that is to validate some expertise and some experience that I don't necessarily have, but hopefully that'll help me out.
Perfect. Good luck with that. Tell us how we can support you. And are you a runner as well? I see some running pictures in the back.
Yes. I am a big runner. I'll show everyone. I ran 4 marathons and I'm trying to run every day. And yeah, it's
that's incredible.
Yeah, wow. It's been developed over the past 3-4 years. So yeah, I'm just trying to keep fit, drinking lots of water and only really eating lunch. You know, I've avoiding dinner just because I'm not hungry. But,
well, go Evan.
Yeah. Thank you.
On the running, I mean, I don't know if you guys should avoid dinner, but
yeah.
Really, really, really awesome. Robyn says food is good. I couldn't agree more. Yeah.
Food is good, but when you're not hungry.
Exactly.
Yes.
When you're not hungry, you can skip it and then you feel good. I admit. Really cool. Really cool. I love how we have heroes on the line and on this call. And I want to wrap up because it's pretty much the end. Do you guys want to take a couple of minutes if I do a quick kind of ease out with a bit of an imaginary, not imaginary, visualization exercise?
Yeah.
Yeah?
That'd be awesome.
All right. Perfection. So let me just get some music on here.
I'll try and keep the dogs from knocking over the computer.
Try to do that. All right, we'll go back to intro because I love it. Even though it's pretty short. Let me see if I can get a longer version. Hold on one sec. XXX intro. Thank you.
Oh, wow. All right. Okay, everybody. Let's start by stretching. Just stretch any way you like. You've been sitting for almost 2 hours. Let your body loose. All right, take a few deep breaths in and out, just any way you like, first of all, just to relax. Every time you breathe in, I want you to breathe in all the nice, amazing feelings. Breathe in the love, the connection, and breathe out anything else. I think this song is a little bit too hyper for us, so I'm going to change it as we go. Take a few more breaths in like that and think about what emotions you feel like putting into your body. Maybe it's something you got from somebody sharing today. Where's the song I'm looking for? There we go. All right. So one more diaphragmic breath and close your eyes when you take it. And really take a moment to feel how the air coming into your body is a little cooler. And when you take it out, notice how it's a little warmer. Take another slow breath like that. Feel the oxygen. And let it out. I want you to close your eyes and realize the separation between your body that's sitting there and your awareness and your consciousness, the real you. Think about how your body feels right now. Think about the space around you. And ask yourself, if I'm the one that experiences what my body is feeling and what's around me, and who is this person being aware of all of this? Connect to that deep part of you that is disconnected from anything external. And just be the being inside that feels, that loves. Feel that love, feel the love of the people on the line, feel the love of the people around you that you care about. We're going to take a few power breaths like we do at the event. You're going to put your arms up next to your shoulders. And we're going to take 30 deep breaths through our noses. We're going to do it rapidly. And we're going to do it 3 times, starting now. Go. Thank you. just inhale and exhale. And we're gonna go again. Go. Inhale and exhale, and the third time, make sure that you have really powerful deep breaths and that you're taking all the energy in. Go. This time, when you're done, put your hands on your heart. Feel your heart beating. Think of how amazing it is that your heart is beating right now and allowing you to be here on this call and be on this earth. Appreciate it. I want you to pick something really, really small that you can be grateful for right now. Something tiny. Something that you don't normally think about. The color of your hair, or your toenails, or just having, you know, all your arms and legs, or being able to laugh. Anything that comes to mind. Be grateful for it. Just think of what it allows you to do. I want you to think of someone in your life that you could be grateful for, someone who really makes a difference for you. Someone that if they weren't there, life just wouldn't be the same. Think about them. Think about the energy that they give you throughout your life. Breathe in that energy for a moment. Let the gratitude within you, let it form a big ball of warm energy, warm fire. Feel it moving in your body. Feel it touching every part of your body, going down to your feet. Slowly climbing up all the way to your head. And when this ball reaches up around your head, I want you to feel how it's soothing and calming down and relaxing everything around your head, whether it's your muscles on your face, or it's the thoughts in your head, or anything that's not relaxed there. I just want you to feel it melting down, getting wrapped inside that ball and turning into this big ball of abundance and beauty and love and gratitude. And I want you to feel that ball of fire lifting up through your head, lifting up above you. And I want you to feel it taking with it all this power. You control this power now. See that ball above you. And it has your favorite color. And you love the ball. Just experience how beautiful and powerful that ball of energy is that you created. And I want you to think of a place or a person that you want to give this ball to energize. And I want you to send it there, and I want you to
see the journey of this ball getting there to that person or that place. Feel that person or place receiving this gift of love and abundance and gratitude. Imagine what it's giving them and what difference it's making. And just enjoy it for a moment. What's that person thinking? What are they feeling? What's happening there? Imagine the ball just expanding with all of the love and the gratitude that it contains now. And give this ball out to a bunch of other people that you care about. Keep expanding it as it travels between the people that you love. And make it bigger and make it more expansive and make it touch more people and more lives. This is the power that you have within you, and it's touching so many things around the world, and it makes such a difference that you've created it. And I want you to go in your mind to a different place now. From all that love and happiness, I want you to imagine yourself standing in front of a mirror and opening your eyes and looking at yourself. And when you're looking at yourself, you're telling yourself why you deserve to have this ball of fire and love and gratitude. Why do you deserve this power? Tell yourself. What are you grateful for about you? Take a moment and tell yourself and feel it. Tell yourself what you're proud of that you've accomplished. Now promise yourself that you're there for you no matter what. And no matter what challenges you face, no matter what hardships you go through, that you're gonna be there no matter what. That you're gonna carry this ball of love and fire and gratitude and power no matter what. And you're gonna always be able to provide that for yourself. I want you to look in your eyes and tell yourself, I love you. I really love you. I want you to take your hands out and I want you to hug yourself as you say, I love you. Just give yourself a big hug. Realize what a gift it is, what an incredible gift it is to have you for yourself. How amazingly incredible that is, that you get to have all this love. this unconditional love that not many people get to have. And you always have that with you. And I want you to have one last thought and tell yourself this. All I need is within me now. Breathe it in and feel it and say it again. All I need is within me now. One more time and feel that hug and assure yourself, all I need is within me now. You can put your hands down on your knees now. Take a deep, deep breath and release. And in a few seconds when we open our eyes, I want us to say a few words of power to empower us throughout the week ahead and to empower everyone on this challenge and anyone out in the world who's not challenging themselves. So let's get ready for that. All right, everyone. I want you to get ready. We're going to celebrate a little bit. So let's start by clapping our hands for ourselves, first of all. Awesome. All right, what I want to do is something that we all love. And it's, hold on one sec. We're going to do Now I Am the Voice. Yeah. You guys ready? It's been a while for me. If I miss a part, I don't have it in front of me. You guys can fix it. All right.
I got it in front of me.
You have it in front of you? Okay, so you can write it down in the chat if I get it wrong. Hold on one sec. I'm just trying to find the right song here. All right. Oh, cool. Thank you. You guys ready?
Yes.
Now I am.
Now I am the voice.
Now I am the voice.
Repeat after me. We'll do it again. Now I am the voice.
Now
I am
the voice.
I will lead, not follow.
I will lead, not follow.
I will create, not destroy.
I will create, not destroy.
I will believe, not doubt.
I will believe, not doubt.
I am a force for good. I am a leader.
Defy the odds.
Set a new standard. Step up. Now celebrate.
Yes.
Totally own it. All right, you guys, a magical week ahead. Have an amazing one. Thank you for being on this call. I appreciate you guys so much, and I love you very much. Have an amazing week. Transcripts after this call and also the recording, if you guys want it. Feel free to dance for a few seconds before you let go of us. And goodbye.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Damn, you need to make a CD. Thank you.
Bye, everyone.
Ciao.